Greetings, I'm Sheldon Zhang, and today is the second day of the Feast Must Fall protests here in Port Elizabeth and at other universities across South Africa. I'm going to take you with me right into the action and ask a few people about what they think about the situation and also just give you an idea of what's happening. If you want to know more about Feast Must Fall and the events that have happened since October of last year, then look in the description, there should be a link there. Many students have parked outside the closed buildings of Edemimu since we can't really go in. Behind me, the entrance to North Campus is blocked. As you can see, right behind me is where all the action is happening. All around campus it's quite dead except for this point. This is one of the main entrances to South Campus and is disallowing students to get to their classes. Let's go see if we can take a closer look.
Kanisa, I'm doing third day in politics. Actually what is happening there is Feast Must Fall.
Yeah, Feast Must Fall.
My opinion on it is that I actually would want Feast to fall.
Yeah, me too.
But how it is done, It is how I don't approve of.
Yeah.
It's like we're actually fighting also against the poor that we actually say we're fighting for.
Yeah, exactly.
Because we're stopping them from getting the education we have now.
Yeah.
So that they can get free education in 2018. Yesterday there was a mass meeting by the SRC,
yeah.
And then actually the way forward is provided by students, not by the student leaders.
Yeah.
Do you want the university to shut down?
No.
This was no.
Yeah.
Do you want actual curriculum activities to actually
continue.
Go on?
Yeah.
And the students said yes,
yeah.
Simply because they were going to provide solutions to the government.
Yes.
And then the government will answer.
Yeah.
One of the best solutions was that at least the government should pop up a percent, which is going to be free.
Yeah.
And then our parents will pay another percent, or our bursaries will pay another percent, which is the way forward instead of saying free education.
Mm.
But so us as students, we need not to engage in violence,
yes.
And as well as provide a barrier for students to get education, but rather give forward solutions.
Wow, there you have it. That was a beautiful opinion. Thank you so much. So how do they tweet about it and then the students see?
Yeah, they post on Facebook. I actually follow them. They post on Facebook and stating actually that they're going to shut down. And it's similar, not only.
Yeah. But right now I'm here with, what is your name, Buti?
Rico.
And he's a security guard here at Edemimu. How has the Feast Must Fall protest affected you?
I think it's quiet.
Yeah, it's quiet.
Very quiet.
So it's been peaceful.
It's peaceful.
Okay,
yes.
Okay. Thank you for your opinion. Is there anything else you want to say?
No.
Thank you, man. Have a good day further. I'm here at the protest Feast Must Fall with Kwanele. Kwanele, how has this affected you? Yeah. Personally for me, I didn't have to write tests, so I'm happy.
Me too.
But I guess some people find it inconvenient and they're not here and they don't really understand what the cause of all of this is. Well, there you have it. Thank you. Right now, I'm here with Lucanio. What do you study, Lucanio?
Okay, I'm currently doing my third year in BCom Economics and Stats.
Yeah. Oh, nice. I'm going to major in Stats.
Okay, sure.
Nice. Yeah. So, what is your perspective about Feast Must Fall here today?
Okay, what we're busy doing right now, I think it's very valuable. It's part of the pace. Because now what we're trying to actually do is get the universities to put pressure on the government.
Yeah.
And the only way that's going to achieve is if we actually have like a coordinated movement.
Yeah.
And that's if we actually shut down and actually cut the access completely. Then maybe they will actually, you know, talk to us, you know, and meet us at least halfway.
Absolutely.
You know?
Absolutely. So, thanks, man. Right behind me now, ladies trying to get out, but the group of people is just lying. Hello. Okay.
I'm the regional secretary.
And are you studying here at NMU?
Yes, I'm at the
Okay, cool. So, what is your perspective about what's going on here with the Feast Must Fall protests?
Well, I think the Feast Must Fall protests should not be taken away from the call that has been made by SASCO in the past 2 years of free education.
Yeah.
Because remember that there are students in the country that cannot be able to access based on their financial position.
Yeah.
And a country without an educated youth is a country that is doomed to fail or collapse in terms of economy.
Yes.
So we're saying we need to widen access for students, for learners in the institutions of higher learning.
Yeah.
That's what's basically about it.
Thank you, Bruce. Thank you. Well, there you have it from the Regional Secretary of SASCO. Thank you so much. Have a good day further.
Thanks, man. Thanks, man.
So that was a closer look at what was actually going on there. There's no filtering happening here, unlike what happens on mainstream media. That is the main intention of this YouTube video. So if you liked what you saw and you found it was informative, then be sure to subscribe. The button should be down there. Hit the like button and share this video with your friends. Until next time.